must succeed. Let's make sure that history never forgets the name Enterprise. Picard out.
Our lives are different to anybody else's. That's the exciting.
Well, I have to tell you, I have no idea what's going on there. That was really weird. What happened with that? What happened with that? Let's try that again. Let's try that again. That was just weird.
Succeed. Let's make sure that history never forgets the name Enterprise. Picard out.
Our lives are different to anybody else's. That's the exciting thing. Nobody in the universe can do what we're doing.
Greenville, I am calling battle station. Anything can happen in the next half hour.
Oh, hundreds and hundreds, but don't worry. I started a very long time ago.
Calling the War Council of Gallifrey. This is the Doctor.
You might say I've been doing this all my lives.
Good luck.
Standby.
Ready.
Commencing calculations.
Turn me there.
Across the boundaries that divide one universe from another.
Got to lock onto his coordinates.
And for my next trick, I didn't know when I was well off. All 12 of them.
No, sir.
All 13.
Yes, indeed, Lodon. Yes, indeed. I worked out the mystery. I worked out the mystery that you may not have been, what's the word? Attuned to, right? I've worked out that mystery. What happened was, when the title started, then I heard the sound looping. Weirdly, I heard it like, you know, Picard say, we must succeed! And make sure history never forgets the what was it? The name. And then it was like, we must succeed! Like, going over himself. What's happening with that, mate? And I was like, well, that's weird. So I stopped the video, and it's kept, one of the tracks kept going. And it was strange. It was strange. And then I realized I had a window open of the stream with the sound on. So it was just one bleeding into the other. Man, I've had agita tonight. Good evening, afternoon, morning. I have had agita tonight. Let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, it's a Jewish holiday of Purim. Okay. We'll go through the practical before the metaphysical. Jewish holiday of Purim, right? When it falls out on, well, the day it falls out is even confusing, okay? It really is, right? You can celebrate Purim on the, I think, 13th, 14th, and 15th of the month of Adar. I think maybe even 12th. There's a whole tractate of Jewish lore about this holiday, and the whole bit at the beginning about how many days you can celebrate it. Look, this is a weird ass holiday, man. A weird ass holiday. But the upshot is this, right? The day before the holiday, you have a fast, the fast of Esther. I'll explain what that is in a minute. And then the first thing you do is you hear this scroll called the Megillah. Have you ever heard? Oh, it's a whole Megillah. That expression, that Jewish expression, that's where it comes from. The Megillah. We read the story of Purim, right? And it's quite entertaining. It's also somewhat interactive. People dress up. People do shtick, I tell you. It's really painful when really not funny people make jokes. It's like, oh, so much cringe, right? Right? Because, you know. Okay, essentially, I would say the people though who were good at fun, right? And basically, my synagogue, fun and enjoyable, don't have so much to do with it anymore. Me being a principal one, frankly. And I was quite famished tonight because I had to temporarily assume the role of a Gabbai, which I was not happy about at all, right? At all. I was miffed about that to start with. I'll tell you about that in a second. So yeah, so then you read the script, and then you know, kids go off to parties, that sort of thing. And the next day, you when you go to synagogue in the morning, they read the scroll again, and we make up these little packets of food. It does it's nicer than it sounds. They normally have a theme, you know. We try and we put things together, but we do particularly cool ones because if you hadn't noticed it, baby, we're particularly cool. Actually, do I have any pictures of the ones we've done? We did like a great cowboy one. They put it in a cowboy hat, and there's like you know, edible rope in it, and all this like cowboy stuff, right? And we always do a there's a little Grace After Mills prayer fold out thing you can get, which I always make my own one for this holiday. So people collect them, right? People who get the good ones, they collect them. It's like, well, what are you doing this year? I haven't done Flintstones yet. I would like to do Flintstones. Anyway, so this year, I give you a normal year. Normal year, then you have to go out in the car, you know, and you schlep these little things to everybody, and the streets are packed. People are wearing costumes. It's just like, it's a nightmare, right? It's a nightmare. But we get through it, right? We get through it, Dunkirk spirit and all that, right? And then we go home, and then you twiddle about a little bit. Maybe have a L'chaim or two. L'chaim, right? Then after the afternoon prayer, you go to a festive meal where you get shit-faced, right? I tell you, I know who I'm going to stop by because I bet there's going to be a lot of weed at that one. It's like the one right next to me. I am so stopping there. Hi, I just thought I'll stop by. Although this year I'm drinking wine. Normally I do tequila, right? Normally I do tequila, salt and lemon. My stomach's a bit delicate. I like wine, right? I'm an old fart now. So we have a local winery. I got a nice bottle of... I got a few like Merlots and Pinot Noir, and this nice like Swedish wine, delicate sweet wine. It's not like heavy sweet wine, which I will start off with, right? And that might well do the trick. I'm not a huge drinker, right? Genuinely not. Anyway, but this year, it's all for mish, right? It's all for mish this year, ladies and gentlemen. Let me tell you, it's all for mish. It's all for mish. And I'm verklempt, okay? I'm verklempt. That's for Mish. Okay, what this year, because... Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Go for that. Why not just go fly? Because we have at home from the Holiday Emporium. And one oven, the dairy oven, right? If you turn it on, it's still there. I'm still here. Okay. It says I'm connected. Okay. I think we're okay. Anyway, it trips the whatever, and so it just had to reboot the router. Oy vey, ladies and gentlemen. Anyway, for Mr. Klemp, right? Purim night, because it's on Saturday night, right? Therefore, the fast is pushed off till Thursday, right? That was what I did on Thursday. Now, Saturday night, you can't start it till Sabbath is out. Sabbath is out at 6:30, right? So I assume 6:30, they would do the evening prayer, Maariv, right? Avit, as the Israelis say. And straight after that, you read the Megillah. You want to read the Megillah? We got the Megillah. Then you read the Megillah, right? You read the Megillah. That takes guessing the length of a Megillah reading is tough, right? Because it's somewhat interactive. Because every time you say the name of the bad guy, Haman, you go, bah! And oftentimes everybody brings their kids to the synagogue. And, you know, we try, I go to the grumpy old man group, right? And I always hope that's going to be quicker because we're grumpy old men. But we also got grandkids. So, you know, yeah, that's where grumpy old men come across the rocky shores. But yeah, so you never know how long it's going to take. A reading of it could be anything. Fastest somebody said is 16 minutes. I've never heard of that. I think I think 35 is a average, right? We were like 42. I was like, oh god. So here's the thing. I thought that's what we're doing. It's starting at 6:30. By 6:15, we'll start Megillah. By like, you know, 7:30 max. Max. I'll be home. Maximum. Right? No, ladies and gentlemen, that was not to be, right? That was not to be. Because unbeknownst to me, they changed the start time to 7 o'clock. I'm back. Beyond me. The entire rest of my family got there, even though they had an extra half hour, they got there late. And so they went to the next Megillah. I'm like, and so they were even late. I'm like, oh. And I need like 5 minutes to come down, right? Before getting online. Man, so I've had agitator this evening. Much agitator, but I'm here for you, ladies and gentlemen. I'm here for you. Tonight is Purim night, ladies and gentlemen. Purim is a funky, funky holiday, right? And I realized while I was listening to the Megillah being read, very well, if I may say so, but a very nice gentleman. I like the guy who reads it. He's a real, I say, Baal Midot. Midot is good characteristics and Baal's master of, right? He's he's a nice bloke, right? Essentially, right? I like him. He's a very decent bloke. I like him a lot. Like, he was one of the first people to bring COVID into the synagogue. And because he's so nice, people gave him a pass. Because he's like, he's that decent a bloke, right? He's like such a decent bloke. I really like him. Anyway, I digress. What were we talking about? Him reading the beginning? He did quite a good job. Because I like him. Anyway, what was I up to? Fine. So yeah. So, anyway, for these reasons, I'm like, I haven't seen the trailer yet. I'm going to be watching the trailer live. You're going to get my live reaction, right? We're going to be looking at the news. The news seems a bit funky, right? The news seems a bit funky to me from what I'm hearing. Like, all right, we should talk about what Purim is theologically. Will have a practical ramification. Let's wait and see. Have you ever seen A Very Peculiar Practice, right? Which is a very good early 80s weird rom-com. I know, how would you describe it? It's like a romantic drama about this kind of like a lost adrift at life doctor. Working in a university, and he's very earnest. He's played by Peter Davison, and it's about him, like, he's free falling through life essentially. But it's a really interesting little study on what universities what's his name's in it? Ian Cuthbertson's fantastic. Ian Cuthbertson's fantastic in everything. And they got David Troughton? It's one Troughton, it was also very good. And what's the name? Who they finally roped into the Jodie is. What was her name again? Great actress. But playing a very sexy lesbian. Quite successfully, actually, I might say so. So a very sexually powerful lesbian, right? yeah, I think that's definitely a fair description. Anyway, so at the end of it, everything seems to have imploded at the end of the first season. His entire life seems to completely implode, and nothing he wants happens. And then one thing happens, and they were talking all the way through it about chaos theory, about how you get to one part in the math and suddenly flip, everything goes inside out, right? And that's what happens at the end of this episode, the end of that season. It was very like it was a strong ending. It's a great show. You should really check it out. It's got a great theme tune. It was a hit, as I was it Bonnie Tyler? It feels like it's Bonnie Tyler, right? But it's good. So that is the Holiday of Purim, you know, in essence. It's a weird story, right? Which really highlights how little we understand temporally foreign cultures. Like, we have no conception of life in, you know, 800 AD Persia, right? We're like, how are they? It's so bizarre, right? Because it's a weird story. Or it's a weird, horrible story, right? It's essentially of like sacrifice and sacrifice for the love of God and the love of Jewish people, I would say, right? It's about It set the times of the first exile of the sorry the second exile. We're in the third exile now, right? Second time, the second exile, the Persian exile, the Babylonian exile, I should say. And Ahasuerus was the king, who was basically Donald Trump, right? Basically, Donald Trump, who was a character in Game of Thrones, so he's like, you know, shagging and killing people too, right? Yeah, that kind of Donald Trump. Right, and if that really is very braggadocious, imagine Donald Trump in Game of Thrones. That's who Ahasuerus was, right? That's a perfect analogy. Man, that is a perfect analogy. I'm quite impressed with myself. Anyway, I'm sorry, I'm just stuck with Donald Trump in Game of Thrones. That's such a brilliant idea. I don't know. Like, again, thank God AI isn't too functional yet, because that would be a movie. I hear they're doing another spin-off about Aragorn, I think. I don't know, I can't remember, about the first of the Dragon Lords, right? There's this big celebration. Because throughout the entire Persia, this lavish celebration where they feel the exile for the Jews is never going to end, and they are the supreme rulers of the universe, right? They're very, very, Ahasuerus is very happy with himself. And so he throws a huge, lavish banquet for like everyone. And he does like, for the Jews, he gives them like the bestest kosherish food. I told you, he's like Donald Trump. I will get the bestest kosher food ever. People, I'm not bragging, but people said they would rather eat their own head rather than not eat some of my kosher food. It is that kosher. It'll be on gold plates. It will be like the kosherest, most opulent thing ever, right? And he would display the vessels of the Jewish temple, which was ransacked by him. To show his primacy over the Jewish empire, right? How he had them under control. And most Jews went for it. Here's the thing. It was like me in my local synagogue. Most Jews went for it. They're like, well, it's a free meal. It's kosher. Why make waves, right? One guy didn't, called Mordecai, right? He called bullshit. And they were not happy with him for that. Just to put it that way, he did not go down well. This is why I relate to him quite well. Anyway, it turns out, as a direct result of this, theologically, this guy called Haman was unleashed, who was the king of spiritual king, I should say, of the nation of Amalek. Amalek are like the evil anti-Jew, right? Nazis are Amalek, right? This guy was called Haman. I think he was the same soul as Hitler, right? But he rose to power, and he got the king, bribing him, I believe, Ahasuerus, to give him the okay to slaughter the Jews on the 15th. Or was it 12th? No, the 11th of Adar, because it was Moses's day of his death. But it was also the day of his birth, right? So, and then there's a parallel story that goes on how Ahasuerus is looking for a new queen because his old queen Vashti wouldn't dance seductively. They say politely in front of his party guests. So she got exiled. She was actually the last. Ahasuerus was a revolutionary. He came in, he took over from the ruling family, I think Nebuchadnezzar, and this was the final daughter of the Vashti was the final daughter of the royal family that he overcame. So now he's looking for a new wife, and this girl Esther gets put in the frame. Esther is here's where it gets weird. The adopted daughter, prospective wife, both, right? It's really bizarre, because they're like, they're not like, yeah, this is a bit weird. No, it's like, it's a very, very, very culturally different thing. Because there's like, you know when they said that John Barrowman got his dick out a lot on set, and it was like, yeah, what's the problem? Same thing with this, right? So there's a Remerson that's a female rabbi, essentially. She would hate that description. But really incredibly learned woman. Sephora Heller, who I heard speak on this in depth, right? And she really speaks about her feminine, you know, desire for Esther's desire for Mordecai on a spiritual level, right? Which I look, for me, it just seems a stretch, because I have trouble conceiving of anybody really being on the level, right? I really do. But I would take this woman's word for it, right? But anyway, so she ends up having to marry Ahasuerus instead, right? I actually think that, Ivana Trump, his daughter, right? The gorgeous one. I think Ivana Trump is the same soul as Queen Esther. I'll tell you why. Because she was described in several ways as being the most fairest of the land. She was a very, very beautiful woman. Now, again, in ancient Persia, that means something very different. It meant her burqa was a bit hot. I mean, from what I could gather, right? It's really weird how different things were. But yeah. and So she ended up having to marry Ahasuerus. Mordecai told her, look, there's a plan to wipe out the Jews. You might survive it. But, you know, if you believe in God, right, if you think God's real, then you've got to do something, right? I mean, like, otherwise, you know, look, Jews are going to come to redemption sometime or another. You're going to decide if you're going to be part of the Jews or not, right? And so she basically saves the day in a brilliant display of psychology as she, like, pumps up the paranoia and the ego of Ahasuerus and then says that Haman's the bad guy, right? Essentially, right? And she also pumps up the aspirations of Haman, right? She really, it's very, very clever, the whole story. Anyway. So, and then the Jews are allowed to given arms or something to defend themselves. It's a very weird story, right? But anyway, the Jews come out on top in the end. The gallows they made for that Haman, the bad guy, the Hitler guy, made for Mordecai, the good guy. Him and his 10 sons end up hanging on those gallows, right? So there's a fascinating bit in that which refers to the Nuremberg trials. It always blows my freaking mind. It reminds me of something that happened in the real world. I only found out about it on Sabbath. But during the very recently, during the Nuremberg trials, the result of it was delayed. So it was after the Jewish holiday of Rosh Hashanah, the Jewish New Year. So it was in September, October, around, you know, around there, right? They all go kind of quietly, apart from the last guy, Julius Streicher, who was dragged kicking and screaming, crying and shitting himself in terror to the gallows. It's like, I really, that doesn't really bother me at all, strange enough. Anyway, he was, his last words were, today is Purim, the Purim festival. Right, before he's knocked off the gallows, right? Knocked off the chair. But Purim is at this time of year in April. So what's it in March? I say, what's he talking about? That the section where they talk about the 10 sons, there's three little letters in it, right? And this tradition is you have to write them in small and in one big letter, one written super big. And so if you take those letters. They arranged the century and the year that the Nuremberg trials were finished, right? The judgment day, which again was delayed for cause of clemency, right? So they were delayed to go for that year, nobody knew why those letters were put there, because there's a really strange part in it in the text. It's after they hung the 10 sons, Haman and 10 sons. The king talks to Esther and says, whatever it is you want, you can have. I'll give you literally anything. And the tradition is they're saying that God is talking to Esther because she is like, you're God above and beyond. She's done a good job. Let's say that. She's done an awfully good job. So she says, I want the 10 people who are hung today to be taken out again tomorrow and hung in the future. A bit of a weird, like, she wants the 10 corpses rehung. Seems a bit strange, right? Seems a bit strange. Doesn't really make sense. However, if you then say she's talking about not then, but the an adjoining moment in space and time, which would be was it 1946, I guess, the Nuremberg trials, 1947, right? Sometime around there. I think that's what it was alluding to, right? I think that's exactly because they had 10 sons of Haman and one daughter. The daughter killed herself because she mistakenly emptied a chamber pot of water over her father's head, thinking it to be Mordecai, right? One of the 11 on trial, what's his name? Goebbels, right, was trans, right? Oh, yeah, you say was a transvestite. No, let's say, honestly, was trans, right? One of the 11 Nazis on trial was trans. So I don't think being trans was such a social taboo, really, in Nazi Germany. Anyway, weird that, innit? Innit? I don't think too heavily about it. Anyway. and he killed himself by there was cyanide that was hidden in his toilet, right? So yeah, there's these weird parallels. So I do think Queen Esther is Ivana Trump, right? Trump, right? Because Esther was somebody who was Jewish, who was pulled out of being Jewish, right, and into being not Jewish, and very famously beautiful, right, and intelligent, and all these things. And I think Ivana Trump is somebody who wasn't Jewish, who converted to be Jewish, right? They both share this flux, quasi-Jew, not Jew state, right? And they're both very famously beautiful. So I think that's a weird connection, right? I think that is a weird and strange connection. But yeah, we live in weird and strange times, baby. Oh, yeah. So what's the weird connection? I think, again, I haven't even seen the news yet. But as I understand it, that the US wanted to impose a ceasefire on Israel. I'm like, fuck you. Really? Really? Via the UN. And apparently it was blocked by Russia and China. For, because it's not mean enough to Israel. But, you know, it's interesting. But according to my kids, I think they have more knowledge than I do. That the problem they have right now in Gaza is there's nobody in charge. They've just decimated everybody, right? There's no communication network. They are just decimated, which makes it hard to get the hostages back, right? Because there's nobody in charge. There's literally nobody in charge. It's kind of like that bit in Apocalypse Now, where they reach like the end of the Danang River. So they're like, this is the furthest American point. Right, and it's just crazy. It's like so insanely fucked up, right? And Charlie Sheen's like, "Where's your CEO?" And the guy's like, "I thought that was you." That's really bad news if that happens to be the case, right? Yeah, it just opens up. Doink. There you go. Oh, what a great thumbnail! I forgot about that. let's get going, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, we have thing. I got to get to that trailer. I haven't even downloaded it yet. Oh, I'm actually kind of looking forward to seeing that trailer. I'm going to do the chat first, then the trailer. Okay, that's the plan. Let me go. Doctor Who trailer. Doctor Who. The TARDIS. God, it looks pretty gay. okay, fine. Let me. I'm just talking about the thumbnail, right? And again, I'm watching the first few frames as I'm downloading it, and it's like, it's just needlessly chintzy special effects so far, right? Doctor Who shouldn't be about that. I'm sorry to be like a dick about it, but Doctor Who shouldn't be about that, right? Not good news. I don't know. We'll look at it in a minute. Anyway, what? An incredible thumbnail. I'm very, very proud of myself. Let's be honest, I was totally in everyone's spank back at one time. Yes, you were, Nicola Bryant, Wicked of the Witch, a masturbatory fantasy. Thank you for joining us. It's Gemma Coleman in the back, we didn't realise. All I can say to fandom is this. You're welcome. You're welcome. the rabbi, I forgot I did this. The rabbi sat in Shagadelic stream. Make your childhood fantasies come to life. Down, 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 down. Oh, that sounds so tacky. I love it. Doctor Who discontent. Yes, there is. We'll be reading more of that. I haven't even looked at Doctor Who yet. Grant Morrison defends Batman. Yeah, I'm interested to read that. New Doctor Who trailer. That's where we'll be starting later. Doctor Who. The TARDIS. Fine. Only the Stardust is here, and he says, when you watch the trailer, pay attention to the song that's playing in it. It's a shot directed towards outside of Phantom. Okay, why does Russell T. Davies think he's got the latitude to be able to take the piss out of anybody who might watch his shit show? I am sorry that I don't think people with penises are girls. I don't. I'm not stopping them. Do whatever you want. I'm saying my personal opinion. I don't think that, at the very least, right? I think it should be that. Where did I put my phone? It's really totally gone. I don't think people with penises. I think there should be spaces for people, women without penises, if women without penises want that, right? I don't think women with penises get to vote on what women without penises want, right? I think that's only fair. That's me for you. I don't rule the world. Anyway, sorry, Russell, I think that, right? I also like Doctor Who. You need to start getting over your bonkersness, darling, okay? Yeah, I know, that's you. Fine, there we go. The Darren Anthony doing them. And Paul tells us, happy Purim to you. Happy Purim to you, sir. A Freilichen Purim. Yeah, I'll give you a Jewish word. This is Yiddish. Yiddish is the Jewish version of the language they spoke in Blade Runner. You know, they mismatch of German, French, Italian, whatever. I can't even remember what it is. Yiddish is a combination of German, Polish, and Hebrew, right? So the Purim greeting is a Freilichen Purim. Done at that volume. thank God Brian Blessed isn't Jewish. That would be awfully loud. Where are we up to? Darren Evans there, Paul Tosman here. Prayers for your family. Have you watched the dinner? I watched the first 45 minutes of the first episode. It was pretty good, but I got too many other things. I really want to keep on watching the three body problem. That was really good. I really enjoyed that first episode. I'm re-watching Master of the Air, which I also love. Oh, love it. Right? You get that it's a good show when you watch it and then you re-watch it. Like, you savor it. Like now I only really want to understand it and see it properly. Right? The only other show I really did that with recently is Westworld, which, boy, was that a good decision, right? That was such a great decision. Thank you for prayers. Many of my family's home. The only one not home right now actually is in Gaza. I will survive. No, it was like that, though. We love you. That one. I'm not going to try and sing it. This is what we want. what do we think? Do. I think I was referring to changes. Time may change, but I can't trace. I don't know. Fly hand in there. Hey, Rabbi. Wondering if you were streaming about the. Of course, I'm streaming about the new trailer, darling. That would be cray cray not to. That's a happening. That's a, after we get the chat. That is a happening, baby. Where are we up to? Down and fly. Hey, boy. Toes there. To honest, the true. Frozen. A good pass through. That. Oh yeah. So. Zebra Holden Zetatas is here. Hey, Zebra Holden Zetatas, thank you for joining us. I guess we will probably be back by then, hopefully. Ethan Buckheim was here. Are we back? Song that plays in the trailer is Changes by David Bell. I like that. Reception back. Okay, we're all caught up with the chat. Excellent. That was quick. Let us get to the trailer, right? Let us get to the trailer. Doink. Season one trailer. Amazingly, I'm excited. I can't believe I'm excited. I'm genuinely astonished.
Give me the loving.
Oh, fuck me. Okay, my initial reaction was horror cringe. Okay, I'll be honest. Like, give me the. I didn't like the fly. It just seemed. I just don't see any Doctor Who ever doing that, right? Give me the look. I did. Hey, oh, God. Fine, let's keep going, right? That was a real cringe. That was a real. It's my first. I haven't seen this. This is genuinely my first reaction.
Where did he come from?
I don't know, he sort of popped up at the right moment. And then he spoke about time travel.
Ruby,
you want to know my secret?
I have the whole universe at my fingertips.
And I'm all on my own. I'd love it if you came with me.
Who are you?
Alright, I hate to say. He's okay. I don't mind him as a doctor. If I saw him, if this was a fan production, sure, I wouldn't mind it, right? I'm sorry. I think he mainly got the role on his skin color, right? And I'm not diminishing his talent, but look, he is a purse puppy for woke Hollywood, right? They look at it and they always have them stuff, but they never have them talking. Like again, I saw Master of the Air. He was in that, really? Who knows? Same with Barbie, right? I'm not close-minded to him selling me on it. I'm really not. And it's okay. It's not like stopping my enjoyment of it, but like people who say, I can't deal with that, I hear them completely, right? I'm working to get through it, get past it. Millie Gibson really helps, by the way, right? She is a spoonful of sugar that helps all this medicine go down.
I'm the doctor.
See, that was actually okay. When he wasn't the rating. That was actually okay. Let's see that again.
Who are you?
I'm the doctor.
Change me.
It's called the TARDIS. It's a time and space machine.
Is it safe?
No idea.
What if I change history by stepping on a butterfly?
Well, that's not gonna happen, is it?
Oh. What's wrong?
Yeah, okay, it's cute, but it seems as if it's CBBC, doesn't it? Right? We'll see it again, right? It just seems a bit CBBC. I don't know. It seems to lack gravitas, but like, am I being a dick? Season 24 lack gravitas. I think it wasn't very good because of it. It's a balance, right? You've got to do Q, and if he has the medal, right, and like can face off, then it will work.
With all my adventures,
never seen anything like this before.
Oh my, Bridgerton!
This place is completely mad.
Things seem to be turning more and more supernatural.
Is that monster?
No, don't be silly. There's no such thing as monsters. It's just creatures you haven't met yet.
Man, I'm really cringing, right? It's like, oh, it's, and again, I'm not being a dick. I want to like it, right? You heard me say, coming in, I'm excited. It's like, Joss Whedon, Joss Whedon, Buffy 2000s humor, right? It's, yeah, it's just cringe, right? It's just, and they normally have that cover up the lack of story and adventure, right? I don't know. Look, who knows? Not impressed from what I've seen so far.
There are powers beyond the universe, so vast. Could slide into the pit.
This is what we're trying to stop.
I'm still her mum. I need to know she'll be okay. You'll keep her safe.
And he's super not selling to me as a doctor. I'm sorry. He's like, okay, how is it Simon Callow or who was it? Gandalf. Ian McKellen. Ian McKellen, you know, I know he was very open about being gay. But Ian McKellen, you can't tell he's gay on screen, right? It's not like they're be all and end all. It's just like everything about him is being gay. Right? I did feel like... I feel like he wants to be bigger than Doctor Who. I described it once. It's akin if you cast John Lennon as a second Doctor, right? There's too much mugging to camera. Okay, hey, I'm Doctor Who, right here. Let me take my kit off and shove some fingers up my ass for art, right? Like the tight sweater, isn't it? It's very gay, right? It's very gay, man.
I will keep her safe. I promise.
Yeah, I wouldn't trust him in a second. Now, again, I'm really open to being wrong. I would love to be wrong. Right? These are my instant reactions. We're going to go back and watch it again after this. These are my instant reactions. I was like, whoa. man, I wonder what is Dan screaming this? I have to ask him where he is.
It's taken me all this time to change it. What am I here to do? I'm gonna save the world.
honestly, she's great. she is the asset upon assets of this series, right? She is the she is the only thing relatable to me in this whole thing, right? Nothing else is really. I'm sorry. Listen, you made it super duper gay, and it just is, right? That means it's relatable to not that many people. Because there aren't that many people are super duper gay, right? And look, God bless you, be super duper gay, right? It's fine, be super duper gay, but it's like, was that movie Bros, right? The Billy Eichler, when he made it, he was bitching and nobody would say, yeah, because you made a gay rom com. Only gay people are gonna go see that. You know, you kind of, you fucked yourself a bit there, Billy, mate. Same thing here. Now again, I'm struggling through it. I'm trying to give you. Oh man. Is it a lack of confidence in the show? They're putting two episodes together on the first one. Is it Disney's immense incompetence? Right. It could go either way. Could go either way. I don't know. Oh, it's it's just like it's really weird. Like how does this happen? And it looks so cheap as well. We're gonna watch it again. It just looks so cheap as well. They put all this money. It looks. You can see me being boggled.
Everything is possible.
Time may change me, but I can't trace time.
I'm always having a bit of David Bowie in it, right? Absolutely. But I'm sorry. I find the effects in Remembrance of the Daleks more compelling, right? Why do I find it more compelling? Because I'm more compelled by this. I'm not compelled by this at all, right? This unit tower. It's just Russell. Is it Russell's greatest asset? Was his finger on the cultural dial, right? He knew his finger on the cultural pulse. He knew where people were holding, right? He knew where people were holding. And he's just lost it. He's not there anymore, right? He really genuinely, 100%, doesn't know where the nation's holding. He thinks it's that he believes in this weird gay fantasy that everybody's buying. Oh, better for... Yeah, no, we're not. And like, again, live and let live. We're fine. Everybody have your own bloody sexuality. It's okay. Oh, but they don't think it's okay not to think like that. Oh, God. There's no live and let live. I'm sorry. In the queer world, there's no live and let live. They seem to be like fascists to me, right? They seem to really hate coexisting people who don't agree that constant gayness is a great thing, right? What consenting adults doing private? That's my fucking business. What do I care? Be gay. Be gay in clubs. Act out gay fantasies. But why? Why is Doctor Who so gay? Is what I'm trying to say. How do we come up to Doctor Who that therefore has to be really gay? Anyway, so we start off. I don't really like you. This unit, right? I don't really like Gemma Redgrave. I don't really like. Anyway. I like this, but it's just too...
Give me the loving!
That's really bad. Oh, fuck off. Really? Yeah, I tried that again. It's like when you take a second swig. And you go, oh, fuck off. Oh, this is gonna suck. Okay, fine. Let's see if I can bring... Okay, there's two people I want to bring in on this, right? See if anyone's available. One is Mega Geek. Here we go. Hey there. Watching the new Doctor Who trailer live. Like right now, Exclamation mark. Dot dot dot. Ouch. Do you wanna come on? Doink. Yeah, let me send him a link. Okay, let me get that link. Oh, man. I like the slow. This is why I like doing it live. You're seeing the slow revelation, right? The slow dawning of how shit I think it is. It's really shit. Oh, it's really shit. Fine. Let me in. One more in. It's really shit. I'm like shocked how shit it is. Hey there, I am watching the trailer live online and reviewed. First time I've seen it. I'm a bit shocked. Ouch. It's ow. I'm trying to give it its best, but boy, it's rough. Right. If you feel, I'm doing it like literally right now. I'll send you a link. If you can come on, that'd be awesome. It's so shit. I don't know, it's just juvenile.
Where did he come from?
I don't know, he's sort of...
Okay, so do you think over here they're saying, look, Chibnall, you fucknut, this is how you should have done TARDIS on a fucking cliff, you fucking moron, rather than superimposing it on another place they didn't want it there. Maybe. But in public, he's like, oh, Christian, well, you're the best. Let me suck your cock. Right? Let me suck your cock.
Where did he come from?
I don't know. He sort of popped up at the right moment.
David says he found the trailer reasonable. I'm really shocked at how much I'm looking at it. Treated this as a 2005 to now, which could be a drawback in 2024. I don't know. Look, here's the thing. The overwhelming thing is how gay shooty is. Right, and he's super duper gay. And look, God bless him, be gay. I'm not saying don't be gay, but you know, most actors have been gay without screaming at the gay. Right, this is very central. Like that's central to his portrayal. Right now, Millie's good. Millie, I see, is like my entrance away in there, but like. He's not really selling it to me as a doctor right now. And I find these like, look, this was cool. This was really cool in Runaway Bride when we first saw it, right? That was like, we never seen it before. Now it's just like, I can do the same on my fucking laptop. Will you stop? And the truth is, I really, really could. This is not impressive effect. I'm sorry. I really could. I use assets that come directly from YouTube.
And then he spoke about time travel.
Ruby, do you want to know my secret?
I have the whole universe at my fingertips.
And I'm all on my own. I'd love it if you came with me.
Who are you?
Yeah, okay, that whole line, like, I have the whole universe at my fingers, and I would love it if you came. You could tell it was in three different speeches. It didn't feel fluid, right? It didn't feel fluid. Maybe when he speaks, it's actually quite good. Here, I'll show you here. So this, again, she's great. She really, and it's not. She's not even that hot in this. Right, she just sucks me in because she's a competitive, act like a human being. This is the only anchor I have to reality.
If you came with me.
Who are you?
I'm the doctor.
Now, when they did that, that was it. Oh, look, here they call back to David Tennant. Now, people said Jodie's in this somewhere. Now, this was very good editing, I think. I really do.
Time may change me.
It's called... again, it just seems very forced, the smile. It doesn't seem like... And again, look, if it's... I want it to be good, right? I really want it to be good, but right now, it's not selling it to me.
It's called the TARDIS. It's a time and space machine.
Is it safe?
No idea.
Yeah, this just annoys me. All right? It's not fun. It's not funny. It's just... It's a silly waste of money. This is okay for comic books. I hate the lighting. Oh, gosh, it's hot. Yeah, look, I hate the light. This is just silly.
What if I change history by stepping on a butterfly?
Well, that's not going to happen, is it?
Oh,
what's wrong?
She looked hot as a lizard woman. I mean, it's a fun gag, but it's just, I don't know, silly. I don't know. It just seems like let's spend my. It just seems. Oh God. It's okay, but it's not even that good.
What if I change history by stepping on a butterfly?
Well, that's not going to happen, is it?
Oh, why would you say it's not going to happen? I like, what? It seems to me everything's in flux now. Like, Chime is completely changing.
What's wrong?
With all my adventures...
Oh, okay. That's a fantastic. Weirdly enough, okay. Let's look at this. It's a. This is a very 2000 AD vibe, right? This feels very, you know, a Star Wars Strong Jim Dog. Interesting visual, right? Interesting visual take on it.
Never seen anything like this before.
Oh my Bridgerton! This place is.
I love that. Oh my Bridgerton! Again, that was a fine, well delivered. Fuck, she's the only human being in this.
Completely.
Oh God! See this. This looks like it's going to be ridiculous.
Mad. Things seem to be turning more.
Okay, one second, and then there's Millie with a gun. Now, that does look like a Cyberman gun. Doesn't it?
Mad. Things seem to be turning more and more supernatural. Is that monster?
No, don't be silly. There's no such thing as monsters. It's just creatures you haven't met yet.
Okay. I like the line. The line works, but the delivery... Every other doctor would have done that better. Right? Literally every other doctor would have done... That's crazy. That doesn't bode well. Let's go through it, right? What's the line? Let's get the exact line.
Monsters are just creatures you haven't met yet.
There's no such thing as monsters creatures you haven't met. Oh, yeah. Imagine Hartnell doing it. That'd be awesome. Oh, I can imagine Hartnell and Richard Hundell doing it. Everybody comes out good on that, right? Just another dumb TV says that ape the snake bot. I do tend to agree with you. That's how I feel about it. So look, actually, Hartnell doing that, but Troughton really delivering better, right? And affirmatively, Pertwee saying imperiously, and Tom Baker saying it with his beautiful smile at the end, right? Right, there are those things I've never met yet. You know, Davidson will say it somewhat indignantly. You would have Colin Baker say it indignantly even more. So we're going to do it somewhat mysteriously. You would have Paul McGann, he'll be doing it like a little bounding bunny, right? Oh, how exciting! Eccleston will do it with a toothy grin. David Tennant will do it like a cocky smile, and both Matt Smith and Peter Riccardi will do it perfectly. Right, nobody, this is the worst. I mean, like, Jodie might do it about as bad as this.
There are powers
beyond the universe. So vast.
Powers beyond the universe. But now, again, some good visuals, but like, I mean, that's something to do with the clock. I don't know. Look, the Doctor, I always liked being better than us, not being, I mean, I liked him also being a bit shit as well. Like, he got, like, he didn't get good marks in school. He's petulant, right? I like the Doctor not being a perfect person. That's really good. Like, I like how hurt he was when Liz left, right? That was really good. I like not liking to be wrong. The negative qualities make the Doctor, but this just seems like he seems like an idiot Gen Z-er. Fuck off. Like, oh God, another one.
The whole world could slide into the pit. This is what we're trying to stop.
I'm still her mum. I need to know she'll be okay. You'll keep her safe.
Okay, again, we've stopped here. The special effects still look very good over here. And also, the rollout is so stupid. Bobby D. Tempsai says the TikTok Doctor. You are absolutely right. Look, if that's the case and it's popular, it's moved on. And good luck to it, right? It's not my thing, but it totally moved on, right? If it is the TikTok Doctor, right? I'm not impressed, right? But again, this looks good, but the rollout's so insane. It's just so insane. If this was going out on Euronight on its own, I mean, it debuted on May the 4th, right? First, you have the debut to grab people, which no one's going to notice now, right? And then you'll have this episode to grab people. It's the big 60s episode, Jinx Monsoon, like huge effect shots like this. It looks like it'll be huge. You're going to have that... as like your second launch, right? It's just such a dumb rollout, it's beyond belief. The other thing that's dumb about it is, okay, it's at 7 o'clock on Friday, the 11th of Friday, the 10th of May for America, and it's midnight on the 11th for England, where there's no appointment watching in America where there is an England. Right, if they did it at 7 o'clock, launched it at 2 o'clock in the afternoon on Saturday or in America, they would lose nothing. They would have lost absolutely nothing in views, right? They probably would have gained some, because they would definitely gain some. You know why? Because it would have become a global event, right, at that point. Like, let's watch the new Doctor. They could have made it a global event we all watched together. Right, 2 o'clock in the afternoon is fine for East Coast, as is 11 in the morning, right, on a Saturday. Both these things are fine. It would have been a global watch-along event. No matter if it was good or bad, just the marketing of this. So, shit. Ah. And then after that, and you hopefully you get good buzz, right, then you have this episode again, which is very flashy, very noticeable. It's done for shit. This is killing, Doctor. This rollout is killing it, right?
Into the pit. This is what we're trying to stop.
I'm still her mum. I need to know she'll be okay. You'll keep her safe?
I will keep her safe. I promise.
Yeah, look, I'll trust first of all, God. I'm not trusting you.
It's taken me all this time to change it.
So look at the different... again, she's great. And it's not, again, it's not because I'm very horny for her, and I am very horny for her, right? It's because she's genuinely good, right? Great. This is great editing. I really like this. Right? You get to see, like, kind of a breadth of the character a little bit. Okay. She's gorgeous in all of them. she's playing older there, you think? Look, is that, the acting is I think it's a disaster. Like everything else, every other creative decision they made, other than hiring Millie.
To realize what I'm here to do, I'm going to save the world.
Well, I hope she's not planning on doing it in two seasons. Hey, look, if to make this work, to make what I'm watching right now work, he's got to be able to face off against real villains with, like real villains with, you know, metal. Right, the thing that nobody was really sure about with Sylvester McCoy is if he had the metal to do it, and that his screen test was to show that. Right, his screen test was phenomenal. I will pull him out in a minute. This is if his performance, if he can do the performance as the Doctor as well as the, you know, the mincing gay Doctor, which is basically where he is. It, for me, it could work. Or at least I could watch it without wanting to shoot myself. But David Miner says this Doctor could be too ordinary a man. I agree. The Doctor is not an ordinary man, and that's the danger of being forgotten. I think so. Yeah. Colin Archer says you may already have said this, of course, but the great idea to make the trailer featuring the and companion we already know has been sacked. Yeah. Okay. Everything they've done has been wrong. Right, everything that they've done has been wrong. Right, again for the world destroyed in Pyramids of Mars. That'd be interesting. Right, but again, if he can face off against Sutek and do this, fine. But if you can, and I've seen no evidence he can thus far, it's yeah, not good.
Everything is possible.
I mean, yeah, this might not be shit, but probably TikTok Doctor. Right, that's what totally you had. I think doesn't it look cheap to you?
Everything is possible.
Like, look, okay, I just came from watching Master of the Year. That looked expensive. This is cheap. Oh shit! It means we're gonna get Master of the Year trailer. Right, that looked expensive. Okay, Master of the Year and what's the name again? The Constellation, right? Two things on Apple Plus right now that look so much better than this. Like, for all the order, it doesn't look very good. Other than being juvenile and annoying, it also doesn't look very good. Like, bloody hell. This is a real fail. Like a real fail. There we get Constellations. Which is okay. Both these shows, the reasons I like watching them is because they're on HD on my big screen. They look beautiful, right? And they're absolutely stunning. This looks like shit. I'm a bit amazed. I expect it to look good. I'm a bit amazed. I'm a bit amazed. Let me download that. Fine, let's finish this trailer. Oy vey. The model costumes don't work. None of this works.
Everything is...
Yeah. The boogieing down. I know. This Doctor just don't do it for me.
Think it's possible.
Time may change me. But I can't
That wink is so him. This is everything you need to know about this Doctor. This is the entirety of this Doctor. It's so vacuous and empty. At least that's what they're showing me. Look. Yeah, it's so vacuous and empty. Wow. And cheap. Looks cheap here. Okay. Master of the Air. Pull that trailer up. And you'll see something that looks like money's been spent on it.
Come up and knock him down.
Every frame of this looks stunning. This is beautiful.
When you look at it, you don't pay attention to what's really going on. It's kind of beautiful.
Master
Here's the thing. I had Mega Geek was on the other, and we're looking at a trailer for this. I was saying how much I enjoyed this. I really enjoyed this show. Right, but again, I enjoy it mostly for the spectacle. That's why I'm rewatching it. He'll say, "But I can tell it's all fake," and he's right. Right, you can tell it, but for me, I don't think that matters. Right, I mean, like, I can tell the 1980s TARDIS console, the console room was right. It looked fake to me. It looked, fake. You know, the Sixth Bridge looks beautiful in Star Trek. Looks beautiful and fake. All the movies of the 90s I love, like Minority Report and AI, those like the 90s sci-fi movies, like 90s and noughties sci-fi movies by Steven Spielberg, they all have that same look, the same shimmer, the artificiality to it, but I don't really care. It tells a good story, It doesn't matter, again, if it's, you know, Talons of Wang Chiang, you know, or Minority Report. If it tells a story, right? Where but look, again, my point is, this doesn't look cheap. This looks like a production you can be proud of.
We came from every corner of the country with a common purpose.
Go, 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 go!
To bring the war to Hitler's doorstep.
Again, these scenes on a 60-inch screen. Oh God, they're beautiful. 4K. Oh, it's so beautiful.
These daylight missions.
Plus, this is actually, it feels like there's substance to it, right? Again, Power Rangers. It reminded me of Power Rangers, says Mark Milford. Yeah, kind of gives me a headache.
So sad.
Who wants to move?
We lead our boys through.
Yeah, look, okay. The amazing thing about this is it's much like when I saw Titanic. I felt like, oh, that's what it feels like to be on the Titanic when it sinks. This is what I felt. I feel like it was probably like to be in a flying fortress, right? It freaking hell. Yeah, Shooting Gat was in it for like 10 seconds. Oh, and this kid, what's his name? Austin. Well, he is freaking incredible. Oh, I can't remember.
We're getting through this. Even if the odds are stacked against us.
First time in the sawmill, boys.
Now, the thing they talked about all the time about this new Doctor was how much money they had, how dealing with a large budget, being a big budget show. This looks like a big budget show. And I've seen it, right? And it was. What you show me would look like cheap tap, mate.
Let's rack them up and knock them down.
Austin Butler. Fuck me, that Austin Butler. He was great in Dune. Oh, I love Austin Butler. Right. That looked okay. Let's AB it, right? Let's look at the season one trailer. We'll just look at bits of it because.
Give me the loving.
No, oh fuck off. Right, that doesn't look like he's put money. Okay, here's Constellation.
I miss you so much.
I mean, look at these shots. They're beautiful. Give me the loving. I miss you so much. Look at it. Actually, human connection.
I miss you so much.
I miss you too, Mama. Will you be careful out there?
Always.
Right, okay. Compared to
I'm the Doctor.
Time may change me.
It's called the TARDIS. It's a time and space machine.
Is it safe?
No idea.
I'm sorry. This is... Where's the season one trailer? This is shit. Fuck me, this is shit. Season trailer? Think I do. Let's have a look. Hang on. I have a folder of, like, useful stuff. And believe me, that is quite useful. Let's see. Oh, I'll come in interwebs. 6th anniversary. Oh, no season one trailer. Come on. Where is it? No. Fine. 1 second. Let's go. Doctor Who Season 1 2005 trailer. You won't come with me? That one. Is that it? Yeah. It was shorter and better. Ah. Hang on. Here it comes. This is really, I'm offended at how bad it is.
Do you want to come with me? Because if you do, then I should warn you. You're going to see all sorts of things.
Okay, you're getting me engaged right away. Right? I mean, firstly, his take on the Doctor while being alien to all the other Doctors, being unique, right? And not my favourite take on the Doctor, feels authentically the Doctor. Let's go back. And I love the music. It's that there's energy and life in this.
Do you want to come with me? Because if you do, then I should warn you. You're going to see all sorts of things. Ghosts from the past. Aliens from the future. The day the Earth died in a ball of flame.
Yeah, he can really run down a corridor, Eccleston. He can't do that now. But boy, look at him.
It won't be quiet, it won't be safe, and it won't be calm. But I tell you what it will be. I'll tell you what it will be. The trip of a lifetime.
Did you notice he didn't keep saying how great he is?
Trip of a lifetime. Trip of a lifetime.
Doctor Who, Saturdays at 7 on BBC One.
Oh, man, that is just so right. Right? It's just so freaking right. I'm sorry, it's not very good. What do you want me to show and tell you? It's not very, it's very disappointing. I think it was made worse by this.
Oh, this is so good. This is so good.
No, it's fucking not. I've just seen it. This is why. Stop telling me it's good and be... Okay, let's look at David Tennant's first trailer. I'm getting more incensed by the moment. Oh, this is so good. Really? You think so? Why don't you just let me watch it and decide? No, you want to tell me. Oh, okay, fine.
I think we've seen it all.
Man, there's low res on this. Look at that.
Think again.
I mean, like, the things that the shooting it to camera really worked. I mean, the TARDIS really worked. His new TARDIS is shit.
Outside those doors, we might see anything.
Again, I didn't really like David Tennant's take on the Doctor, right? It's kind of like irritated me. But still authoritative. I haven't seen that from Chuty yet.
My new world. Terrifying monsters. Impossible things.
And if you come with me,
nothing will ever be the same again.
Man, this was, Ken, you know, this was actually good. You didn't have to keep telling me how fucking good it was. It was just good. And even these monsters were shit. The story was good. Come on. Man, do you remember, like, how fun it was to watch Doctor Who?
Let's go.
Doctor Who, coming soon to BBC One.
Honestly, I think the Doctor is about as relatable as you can get with the Doctor without stopping being the Doctor. Yeah, season 3, 2008 trailer. Let's pull that one up. That's the Martha trailer. How do you fuck this up? It's failing on every single level. Man, it's really doing badly. Right? Here, let's compare it. We'll look at all the trailers, right? I mean, we'll look at Jodas because what? You want me to shoot myself in my face? Stop. Right? Doink.
You seem to be drifting, sweetheart.
I'm not drifting. I'm waiting.
I thought it was pulled up the wrong one. Fine, this is season 4. Three next. I mean, that Chuty Gatwa might be having a visit from a Chinese spy that does look like that, doesn't it? It does look like that.
What for?
The right man. I've seen him. I've met him just once. And then I let him fly away. If you ever see a little blue box flying up there in the sky, you shout for me.
Look, I mean, again, the anticipation and excitement this builds up, right? You'd have to keep telling me, oh, this is so great, right? It's just like the music, it builds up to it. It's got a... this new reiteration is a bunch of four old men without a clue, essentially.
Oh, you just shout.
Sorry, four old men and a couple old ladies without a clue. Oh, do you remember when you were like Doctor was brought you in? Oh, man. I'm so much more into watching this and I'm not... Look at this. Money spent. Look how much better all this shit looks. Money spent for a fucking reason. It's like not just, oh, we got to spend money. This actually looks good. This looks like Doctor Who, right? The other stuff looked like CBBC, right? It looked like it's too juvenile. This is that sweet in between adult drama and kid fun, which Doctor Who should live in, right? It's like an adult show that kids can play in. That, yeah, we can all play in a basket together. I'm trying to rank this in my head. Okay, excuse me. Freema Angerman covered in goo, I think just put you in the lead, don't you? Yeah, fine. Let me start a ranking. Okay, because like I think we got to recall these. So, 1 second. So we had 2005, season 1. Then, over here. season one. We've seen that so far. Is the season two trailer better than the season one? No, I like season one better. You want to come with me? So I'll put season two after that. Season two. Then this one I'm going to put. Let's watch it to the end, but I still prefer the season one. And we did get chills that Rose was coming back.
Chrissy's still out there, somewhere. And I'll find him, Gramps. I'll find him.
Oh, them were the days when Doctor was really working. 2007 trailer is the one I want. They called up the wrong one. Come on. It's thinking about it. Oh, coming into webs. Don't die on me now. You were just doing so well. Uh-oh. Okay, I'm still on, but it won't... man. Come on. It's... YouTube's just frozen. That's bizarre. Maybe I'll try opening in a new window. YouTube. Internet seems to be working. Yeah. One second. Where's the... So I'm going to put the season four trailer above the season two, I think. Okay. Oh, here it comes. Fine. YouTube just came back online. Okay, let's look at the season three trailer. Oh, this is a there's like a 30-second trailer. Isn't there a longer one? Is this it? Season three trailer. No. Ones that were made. This 40 seconds is the only trailer there was for season three. That's crazy. With that 40-second one, I remember there being a longer trailer for season three. Doctor Who season three trailer. Let's try that. Season three trailer, 2007. Oh, is this it? This is from. I think this is all the. Is this the whole trailer? Or is this the coming soon's? I think this is it. Doink. If this isn't the official one, I'll look for the official one. Here it comes. Download. Save video as. I think this is a real one. Season 3, 2007 trailer. Okay. So fine. So we didn't. This is for the fourth one we've done. Let's look at. I did not download yet. Oh, come on, really? Should be there now. Video file. Oh, that is good.
I'm the Doctor.
Me too, if I ever pass my exams.
What was your name?
Martha. Martha Jones.
Yeah, this is the real trailer. I remember it. Right, because it was like restarting. It was refining its feet without Rose, right? It was redefining itself. And Freeman Adjiman really pulled that together.
Martha Jones.
So, here... Her introduction was really perfect. I'm the Doctor, so am I if I pass my exam.
I'm the Doctor.
Me too, if I ever pass my exams.
What was your name?
Martha. Martha Jones.
Rose, my name's. Not that you're replacing her.
You never said I was.
Totally are. Totally are. Monsters! It started. I kind of like Daleks in Manhattan. A lot of people hate it, but man, do I think those Daleks fit right into that 1930s Art Deco. Totally. But look at that. Jadoon being good, right? Being interesting to see. And all of these things have, like, so interested me more than Shooter's trailer, which we're going to watch again. We've got to remind us of how shit that trailer was. See, the things in these that are good are its seemingly compelling characters, right? That I'm interested in their stories and they're doing interesting things. They're screaming, ah, whatever. The new one is a bunch of like fox going, bleh! And it's like watching the Muppet fucking babies. That scene, right? I love that scene where they kidnap Martha.
The Globe Theatre,
Mr. Shakespeare, isn't it?
What are you standing there for? Come on!
Very well dressed for a hitchhiker.
See, again, this is really hits that sweet spot between adult drama and kid TV show. Right, it feels like an adult drama doing a kid TV show, and it's just such a great hybrid. The other one, we'll go back to watch the shooting trailer again after this to remind ourselves, because this is shit. Like, this feels like a real trailer for Doctor Who, and the other one was a pastiche.
Tonight, I'm going to perform a miracle.
I'm 76 years old.
All right, that was exciting, right? That was exciting. That was a good trailer. As a trailer, I thought, I think that trailer was better than season three. So hang on, let's look at that shooty trailer again. Okay, let's go. We'll keep reminding ourselves. Fine. Where was it? Is it a trailer for the specials? This is the Doctor Who 2009 trailer.
Give me the love
it. I fucking hate it. It gets worse every time I watch it. It really does. What's it? I'm going to do Doctor Who 2009 trailer. Let's see if there's a trailer for all of them. There's all these fan-made ones. Is there an official one, right? All right, this is the closest. I think this is the coming soons. Where was it? Download. And then we get to season five, which is, yeah, everybody's favorite, right? Season five. Just fantastic. Right? I love that one. But hey, where's the download? Oh, here it is. Doink. Doink. Thinking about it and download. See a bit more of this.
Where did he come from?
I don't know. He sort of popped up at the
right. And why is it leading out with all the stuff we've already seen? Let's see new material.
I'm the Doctor.
It's called the TARDIS. It's a time and space machine.
Is it safe?
No idea.
Fine. Now let's look at a real trailer. Now we remind ourselves. Shit, we're looking at.
Jason, if anyone had to be the Doctor, I'm glad it was you.
The Feast awaits.
All right, a fan-made trailer, fair enough.
Come with me.
Actually, what was it? Is the next 2009 Next Doctor trailer? Is it? Okay, let's just, I think they got three different ones. Next Doctor, and then we'll do is this it, or is this it? This is the teaser trailer. I think this is it. Yeah, these are quickies. So we got that one. Then there's, what's it, Planet of the Dead? Let's see if we can see video as. Next Doctor trailer. I mean, look, that fan made one's good, but I feel like I'm jipping you. You know, I should really give you the real one. Next Doctor, Planet of the Dead. The Dead. Here we go. Is this a real one? TV trailer. Yeah, this is it. So can I find something higher res? I think this one's yeah, this one's better. Maybe. Who could tell? Fine. Doink. And then fine. I guess we've got to look at Waters of Mars after that as well. Blimey. It's you know, dedication to duty. I guess that's what this show's become. We're gonna do a trailer special. Doink. Planet of the Dead. Next Doctor.
What day is this?
Christmas Eve, sir. 1851, sir.
Nice year.
This creature came out of the shadows. A man made of metal.
It's actually a very effective trailer, right? It's more understated, right? It's a very effective trailer.
What manner of men are they?
Cybermen.
Oh. I love that line and that delivery. But again, it's fundamentally better because the content's stronger.
Doctor!
Monstrous, weren't you?
Merry Christmas to you too.
That seemed like quite a good villain, okay? I think that looked pretty good.
What if I change history by stepping on a butterfly?
Well, that's not gonna happen, is it?
Oh!
What's wrong?
With all my adventures,
never seen anything like this before.
Oh my, Bridgerton!
This place is completely...
Yeah, that's the villain, fucking hell. Look at this. It looks like they're being attacked by a Muppet. Planet of the Dead, which I think is probably one of the weakest ones.
Hold on!
End of the line.
We're on another world.
I mean, the whole thing about that bus being broken up actually kind of worked better. David Morrissey was great as a doctor, I agree with you. And she was a great guest star. What's her name? Michelle Ryan? She would have been a great companion.
What is it? What's wrong? Doctor, tell me.
Every single instinct of mine is telling me to get off this planet right now.
Something is coming. Riding on the wind. They devour.
What is it?
Death.
Again, you don't have to show us like, you know, oopsie doopsie, willy silly willy, ba 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 da da da. No, this actually looks like it's genuinely scary. And it wasn't.
Run, 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 run,
run! That planet out there, all three suns and wormholes and alien sand, that planet is nothing. I'm going to get you home. I promise.
Doctor Who,
again,
Saturday the 11th of April on BBC
One. I was never enamoured with David Tennant's take on it. End of Time, isn't it? End of Time trailer. Do they have one big one for all of them? End of Time trailer. There's a few of them. Yeah, let's look at this one. This one looks like a real one. Let's go back to the ranking in a second. Let's have a look. What was that written down so far? We've got season 1, 2, and 3, 4. So we got Planet. Then we have, what's it called again? What's that Sideman one called again? Next Doctor. Where would I rank that trailer? Yeah, 1 second, share screen. Doink, stop screen. Share screen. Where would I rank the next Doctor trailer? I should rank that quite highly. I thought it was pretty good. Season 3 one was very good, though, right? That was the... No, I'm going to put Next Doctor above that. Next Doctor. Then we have Planet of the Dead. Well, that was a strong trailer too, right? That was a strong trailer too. Well, I'm going to put that over here. Planet of the Dead. And then we got to see Waters of Mars, right? That's the next one. That's where we're up to now. Did I download one? The Dead. Doink. Waters of Mars. I forgot that one. Here, let's go grab that. Waters of Mars. That should be a good trailer. Waters of Mars. Ah! Doink. This is the official one? It looks like it. Was that one? No, I think this is it. No, that's it. Is this one over here? Yeah, we go. Doink. Doink. Where are we going? Here we go. Let's have a look at this one. Waters of Mars. Let's have a look at that one next.
Name, rank, and intention.
God, I was very right. Did you catch Bridgerton reference? They're even referencing their own blackwashing of history. That's so true. Yeah, this is a weak trailer. It just makes me want to go pee.
Roof.
Water always wins.
Yeah, okay. We're calling that a shit trailer, okay? That's a shit trailer. Water of the Mars, you go right at the bottom. Okay, that was not good. Waters of Mars. Fine. Let's look at the next Doctor. Oh, no, End of Time, I should say. So far. End of Time. And then we'll get up to Matt Smith, where we'll see really good things.
Sometimes I think the Time Lord lives too long.
The day is almost upon us. This is the Doctor's final battle.
I don't want you to die.
It feels like it's running out of energy, right? Thank God they regenerated. This was good, but it feels like they're running out of energy at this point.
This should be spectacular.
Gallifrey.
Timothy Dalton just saved that trailer. That was, look at that. There is nobody with that sort of same power in Tutor's trailer.
Lefray rises.
The Time Lords are returning.
At last, we are gathered for the end.
The 10th Doctor's final adventure concludes. Doctor Who, New Year's Day at 6:40 on BBC One.
I mean, it was huge. It was a big deal, okay? Yeah, they build up to it nicely and...
What's wrong?
With all my adventures...
Never seen anything like this before.
Oh my, Bridgerton! This place is completely...
I can't say what they say. I've never seen something like this before. You've seen fucking everything, you cunt. You absolutely have. Will you stop? I've never seen anything... Really? Where have you been? Because I have. I'm watching the same show as you. One second. Now we get a bit of Matt Smith action. Season 5. Where is it? Doink.
My name is Amy Pond. When I was seven, I had...
One of the all-time greatest trailers. I mean, this is a hard one to beat.
An imaginary friend. Last night was the night before my wedding, and my imaginary friend came back.
All of time and space, everything that ever happened or ever will. Where do you want to start? Anywhere you want, any time.
I mean, you get such a sense of like vastness, right? With this one, like this expansive, wonderful adventure. This new one seems so small compared. I mean, this is like a huge. This is a huge romantic story told on a massive tapestry throughout time and space.
You want one condition. It has to be amazing.
Starts.
You might want to find something to hang on to.
It begins!
I mean, yeah, you were even making Chimnall look good! Yeah, this looks genuinely. I'm like, man, I'm so excited. And again, notice how it's not doesn't feel silly, right? Compared to again.
What if I change history by?
I'm sorry. This is just a ridiculous waste of money. Put them on, have them on wires and stump people. It's a ridiculous waste of money in a boring ass TARDIS. Every penny is here is to tell you a story, a compelling story.
One simple instruction. Don't follow me under any circumstances.
Oh, they see, look, it's about somebody other than the Doctor. They have some guest stars. Oh, no, we got Jinx Monsoon. Yay. And Cocksucker General. I mean, like, these people, they call guest stars. Like, oh, we're so excited. We got the guy who stuck his finger up his ass in the TikTok video. Really? Yeah, that's impressive. Really, this had Toby Jones.
Any circumstances?
Will you follow him?
Of course.
Because this is what I do every time, every day.
Even James Corden wasn't annoying. Fuck me. Look at Hitler. Look at Churchill.
Every second. This. Hold tight.
Because it will change your life.
There's one thing you never put in a trap if you're...
Like every line he's saying is inspiring me as a doctor. Not one line here. Let's go back. Okay, I mean, let's be fair.
My secret. You want to know my secret?
I have the whole universe at my fingertips.
And I'm all on my own. I'd love it if you came with me.
Who are you?
I'm the Doctor.
Really? I mean, look, this guy seems like the Doctor to me.
If you value your continued existence, if you have any plans about seeing tomorrow, there's one thing you never, ever put in a trap.
Oh, man, Murray Goulburn, it was good. And also, you had Karen Gillan. Karen Gillan is such a stunningly great actress, right? She really is. I mean, I'm really glad for her continued success. I think she should have more. I think she's just genuinely a good person, right? Okay, so yeah, this one is hit knocking out the park, right? This one is really doing it well, whereas... the current one, not so much. I didn't tell you. Every trailer I've seen has made me want to watch the story so far. Not apart from Shooter's one.
Me.
Okay, so again, I like that they have a very unique feel to the Matt Smith era that feels like Doctor Who and original at the same time. Let's look at. I think this continued in series 11.
The Doctor's darkest.
Oh, series 11 wasn't as good as. I mean, not series 11. I think this continued in series 6, but which I don't think was as good as series 5.
This is the Doctor's darkest hour. He'll rise higher than ever before and then fall so much further.
This is the day he finds out who I am.
Hey, bye, bye, Grump.
Okay, that was a good... They wouldn't even be able to do that now because it'd be socially... what's the name? Insensitive or something. Like, for fuck's sake, it'll be insulting Muslims. Because it'll take the piss out of the North. I don't know what to tell you. But, yeah, look, season six had a very good flowery speeches, and it just didn't come together as well, but it looks pretty darn good. Yeah, okay, one second. Let's compare effects. This was, what year we're talking about this? This is, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This is 2010. So it came out to 15 years old, right? Let's compare. Right, let's have a look. All right, that looked pretty darn awesome.
Give me the loving.
Not so much. Just not so much.
Where are we?
Where we've never, ever been.
Look how cool this stuff is.
I mean, to a great extent, Series 6 really coasted on the incredible performances of everyone, right? And how likable everybody was. But it really did coast on those things, I think, right? But that being said, they all were so incredibly like, and they were great performances, and they all were very, very likable. So, you know, for me, it's all okay, right? It's all totally okay. Man, I like Hugh Bonneville as the captain.
Fear me.
Yeah, they were actually scary villains. Like, again, I'm saying nothing that actually looks in any way scary in this new one.
Fear me. I've killed hundreds of Time Lords.
Fear me. I'll kill all of them.
I love that line. Man, I forgot how great this was. Right? And like, when he's scared, it actually seems real. I like Daniel Mays as well. Right? Again, this isn't like, oh, you're going to love this so, so, so much. It's going to be so... What? This era, every season was so fucking epic, right? I didn't need Matt Smith to come on and say to me, oh, this is the best thing ever. Oh, I didn't need Matt Smith to come on Snapchat and tell me this.
Oh, this is so good. This is so good.
Okay, this is going from confidence to being a cocky cunt.
I've been running my whole life. Now it's time for me to stop.
Doctor Who, coming soon to BBC One and BBC One HD.
Oh, man. Okay, fine. Let's go back to the rankings. Because we just saw some awesome freaking trailers. Let's go back to this for a second. Okay. Water of Mars. That was really naff. End of Time. I'm going to put that over here. Imp of Time? The season 5 goes right up here, mate. And then season 6 goes right next to it. These are just excellent, strong trailers. Right? Excellent trailers. Fine. So, I think let's go to... where am I? Fine. So, let's go to... we dealt with season 6. Let's look at season 7. Or should we look at the 6th anniversary trailer? Where was it? Let's see what trailer it is. 6th anniversary specials. Oh, no. 6th anniversary. Fuck off. We're not there yet. I thought it was the 50th anniversary one. My mistake. Video file. Do you have the 50th anniversary? I thought I did. Ah, so I got here. We'll just go to season 7.
So, how much trouble are we in?
Again, they had built up such an incredible rapport by this time. They could really get away with a lot, right? They could really get away with a lot. And just seeing these people, because you loved every one of the actors, right? And they were like part of there. The dark. This is just hitting every, you know, on every cylinder for the normie public.
You got me. What are you waiting for? At long last, here I am.
Ball's the opening, isn't it? I love that.
Dinosaurs on a spaceship. We're very cross with you.
They're a bit CBBC, but I kind of liked him, the guy from Sherlock.
Today, I honour the victims first. His, the Masters, the Daleks, all the people who died because of my mercy.
See, this is what happens when you travel alone for too long.
We'll get through.
I forgot how good that was.
Yes, I promise. Don't be scared.
Scared? Who's scared? Geronimo.
I love Karen Gillan. She was a great companion. Man, I would love to see Karen Gillan with the Third Doctor. That would really go nicely. I was kind of sick of River Song by then, but again, you can feel the whole era just getting like, yeah, okay, then let's move on.
Who killed all the Daleks?
Who do you think?
Okay, compared to. I'm sorry that it's shit, but it's shit. What do you want me to tell you? Where are we up to? Let's have a look at this next one. Where is this next one? Oh, we go here. And then this is the last Matt Smith one before we move on to Capaldi. I guess we're doing a full trailer comparison. If I had planned this show out, it would have been really cool, right? I'm quite happy with the idea that. So, okay, fine. We'll get that next. So doink. We might even go crazy and look at the first Jodie one. I don't think I can get through it. Okay, maybe we'll. I don't know. Just to shout at the screen. I didn't download it. Here we go. Doink. Serious. Oh, serious. Here we go. Doink. Well, pulling up the wrong one. Video file.
Our Father. Who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done.
Face me!
Run!
Is this the wrong one? Oh, come on! Where is it? God, I downloaded the wrong one. Let me find the right one. I like, it literally just said, Season 7, Part 2. Right? I mean, like, well, what does that mean then? Yeah, we'll try again. We'll find it this time. Doctor Who Season 7 trailer. I just put Season 87 trailer. That was a mistake. We'll try that again. Season 7 Part 2. Oh, is this it? Is this an official trailer? I think it is. Oh, this is it. Is this it? Yeah, this is the Martha trailer. I'm not Martha. I mean the Clara trailer. Where'd it go? Doink. Okay. Fine. Now let's switch up to this one. There you go. Definitely part two.
What happened to me?
Don't you remember?
You are the only mystery worth solving.
Right then, Clara.
Again! Streaks ahead! Like, streets and streets ahead of this shooty piece of this cheap shooty piece of shit. It just looks like small and tacky compared to this.
Oswald, time to find out who you are.
Run, you clever boy.
You have no idea what you are dealing with. I've seen bigger.
Really?
Are you joking? It's massive.
This is a really good trailer. I'm sorry. This has got me excited to watch it. I get sucked into it. Who were?
I am the Doctor.
And I am afraid.
Doctor Who starts Saturday, 30th of March on BBC One and BBC One HD.
Next to...
the whole universe at my fingertips.
And I'm all on my own. I'd love it if you came with me.
Who are you?
I'm the Doctor.
It just looks so small. I'm sorry. Okay, so let's go. I think this is probably what the weakest season of New Who up until 2007. I like that it's very visually interesting. It seems to be doing something different, which they did in the season one trailer and season two when they introduced new Doctor. Yeah, again, I think I found his first season be weak. I don't think he really knew where he was going with the character. Okay, but this, to me, looks as convincing as this.
It's called the TARDIS.
Where is it? Oh, God. Every time I see it, I ain't get annoyed. No, that looks as... They look equally convincing. I'm sorry.
What if I change history by stepping on a...
Oh, God, stop. Just stop. Millie, darling, you're doing well getting out of this shit show, okay? Don't feel bad. You're doing well getting out of this show. Season was a bit of a misfire, like trying to work out who he was and where he was in the world. But still, I didn't feel like I was watching... You know, completely, complete pap, right? Which again, why do I feel I'm watching complete pap? Look at this.
People are not ready.
What? It wasn't very good. And look at the smug fucking look in his face. Like, you got nothing to be smug about, mate. You've got nothing to be cocky about. So far, everything's been a miss. Right? You're about to go down in flames.
Oh, this is so good. This is so good.
Okay, look, you can be confident if you can deliver the goods. Right? I haven't seen that yet. I don't think anybody has. Right? I really don't think anybody has. You're up to season nine. Let's have a look at season. Late season nine, it got much stronger, I think. Doink. Downloads. Should we look at the Jodie ones? I don't know if I can. You're gonna kill me. There we go. Doink. Series 9. I'm sorry, I find that more convincing than the shit I saw for they spent $1 million on. Way better console room. Oh my God. Did you sense of them not constantly bragging about the Capaldi Matt Smith console room. They didn't they did a bit about his first one, Matt Smith's first one, which was a bit shit. But like Capaldi one, no, they just kept it was just awesome. Yeah, by the time he'd really become the Doctor. And Missy actually became a good villain. Look, the tragedy was that the two-parter that finished his first season failed. It just wasn't good at all, right? And on the paper, it was great. On paper, it was great. In actuality, it failed. I think Missy was a great master, right? I think she encompassed Delgado and John Sim and... what's it called again? The Aether's Master. Oh, my God, I can't remember his name. He did. I haven't seen Shooty save anyone as yet, and I can't really imagine him doing so, right? Hang on a second. Let's grab this one. Do that one. That's the next one. Season 10, I think, was Capaldi's absolute finest. Should have had another three seasons minimally. It's kind of tragic that he didn't, in my opinion. So let's go back, and there's this one over here. Doink. I'm going to download the first Jodie one, see if we can get through it. I don't know. Here, 1 second. Series 11 trailer. Shall we do it? We'll go for it. It's so shit. Yeah. Okay, that's the only way to read that. Yeah, we got to watch the Jodie ones to put it in context. Fine. Oh! It's a harsh thing we got to do, ladies and gentlemen. It's a harsh thing we got to do. But yeah, we got to do it. Again, look, it just seems so much bigger. Doesn't it? It's vaster. It's so epic. So much more like Docket. Everybody hated her, keep saying how much she loved being gay, which, yeah, I agree, was irritating, but mostly she was very good, right? I like that character a lot. I thought Pearl Mackie was excellent. I think the Nardo was a bit off. It wasn't a great... Thank you so much. I think Nardo was a bit off. Bill Paul, really excellent. Really, really excellent. The energy between her and the it's absolutely excellent. Right, knocked it out the bloody park. Right, again, real weight, real gravitas, real fun, real silliness, and it all works together. So much more expensive. It's like, how does this look so much more expensive and was so much cheaper? I don't understand. They made more. Is it Matt Rapp? Is it me or is the rabbi roboting a bit? What's roboting? I don't know. Oh, maybe, but lagging. I don't know. But yeah, how does this look so much better than what they're making now? They made more episodes and it looked better. I don't understand. Yeah, no, it's... Well, let's get back to the rankings. Share screen. Fine. Well, we're up to. We're up to the Planet of the Dead, End of Time. Fine. So season 5, season 6. All the Matt Smith ones are up there. I'm sorry. Season 7, right? I'll put season 7B as well. Let's put them equal to number 3, 7B. So then we had Capaldi's first. Now, that was a weaker trailer. I'm going to put that down here. So that'll be season 8. And we just saw season 9. That was a great trailer. Putting that up there. Season 9. Fine. Let's get to season 10. Or was that? Did we just see season 10? That was just season 10. Yeah, just in season 10. That season 10 was very good. 1 thing. So season 10, oh, wait, I've lost it. It's so season 9, actually, I'm going to put lower down. I got that mixed up. I'm going to put that over here. But season 10, I liked a lot. Season 10. Fine. Let's go into Jody, there's a season 10 trailer too, we'll have a quick look at.
This is the gateway to everything that ever was or ever can be.
Ah, okay, fine. It's exactly the same. Fine, we procrastinate enough. Let's make the shooting up with trailer look better, okay? Let's see. This might really help it, right? This might really help it. Ah! She's useless.
All of this is new to me.
Yeah, you never got into it, darling.
New faces.
This is actually a decent trailer. I'm sorry, you can't really tell she's shit in this trailer.
New worlds. New times.
Okay, again, in hindsight, you can see that she can't run. In hindsight, you know she's shit, but in the trailer, this is better than the shooty one.
So if I asked really, really nicely, would you be my new best friends?
Well, that's a bit cringe, isn't it? Up until then, it was better.
Right. This is going to be fun.
And again, you couldn't tell it was going to be so awful. I'm sorry. This looks really shit.
Well, that's not going to happen, is it?
Oh, what's wrong?
With all my adventures,
never seen anything like this before.
Oh my, Bridgerton.
This place is completely...
Wait, did they have like a black... Is it blackwashed in there? Oh yeah, yeah. Oh my, Bridgerton. So it's hard to evaluate the Jodie one. It's pretty bad, right? As a trailer, if you didn't know it was going to be as bad as it was, fine. You know what? I think it's only fair to put at the bottom. Season 11. Okay, I'm being kind. Like the lowest one right now is Waters of Mars, and I'm sorry, I can't put a Jodie trailer above that. Fine, let's get to season 12. Season 12, where we knew how bad it was going to be. Is this it? Yeah. See, I bet this is going to be a bad trailer, right? I bet this is going to make it look as awful as the shooting one was. Let's have a look. Season 12. Remove. Oh, these are really painful to watch.
The name's Doctor. The Doctor.
The security of this.
Okay. Awful. Oh, we know like smug and unwatchable. Like this. Just like this. Shudi, you got no
people right. Are not ready.
You've got no right to be that smug, much like Jodie.
It is at stake. Can we rely upon you?
I'm not where I wanted to be, but I can work with this.
Yeah, no, you were shit by then. Oh, God. Oh, you were bad.
From Joko.
What? I don't suppose you've seen anything weird around here.
You believe this is a human?
What's the plan? You trust me, don't you?
No. No. And again, I actually find this a better trailer than the shooty one. All right, at least there's some, like, action going on.
Have I got to answer that?
Well, God, that was the worst villain ever.
Are we? Paris, 1943? Oh, no.
she was so shit in this role. And it shows in the trailer, right? And it's that there's nothing about the trailer that makes you go, oh, I want to watch this show.
Things coming for me. I can feel it.
Nothing. Look, irrelevance is coming for you, darling. Irrelevance.
Let it come.
Because we miss.
Let it come. Oh, there's Yaz, the bestest police officer ever. Oh, she's so stunning and so icky and so brave. Icky thump.
Family.
And he said, like, yeah, one person who can act like a human being in that.
Get away from-
and that was actually quite a good effect they just saw. But, like, it's whenever she opens her mouth, it kills it.
Get away from them!
You know things will get into the TARDIS.
What have you brought here, Doctor?
I don't know.
You don't know. You're fucking useless. How much of that episode of that trailer was her staring gobsmacked? Oh, Icky Thump! Oh, brilliant! Oh, Icky Thump! Oh, I'm confused, mate. Fuck me. It's like she's always been so awful as a doctor, right? Unbelievably bad. Right, and her performance just got worse. Right, it literally just got worse. Doink. Well, this has been an interesting. If I build it as this for the show, it would have been quite good. Right, I think this has been an interesting show. I'm quite happy with the way it's turned out.
It's happening again.
Who are you?
I'm the Doctor. This is Yaz. This is Dan.
Again, how they thought this characterization was a good idea is beyond me.
Why don't I know?
Although, I like the Suntaran design.
About this. And who else does?
Very odd.
This is a good trailer. Okay? This is a genuinely good trailer.
Feeling that some of this is my fault.
Run for your life!
I mean, she kills it every time she opens her mouth.
Maybe.
Or is on screen. I mean, she needed a paper bag over her head. That would have been better.
You should have broke that seal a little bit more gently.
Why is that?
No, nobody understood, mate. Right? Literally nobody understood. Again, they were horribly miscast, but this looks like a better trailer.
Our final fight has begun.
Wow. That only works if it's like somebody we would recognize. Oh, look, it's from Terrorhawk.
Stay away from me.
Yeah, and we all, Jodie, stay away from us.
There's no use being squeamish. We've got the future to save.
Yeah, we've got to save the future because I'm the bestest police officer ever I am. Oh, bestest ever.
We don't have any more time.
Okay, I'm going to say that's a reasonably good trailer. Right? I really am. Listen, let's do Power of the Doctor. Doctor Who. Power of the... We've got to go for the whole thing. Power of the Doctor. This was shit. But again, I think that trailer was... the product was shit. The trailer sold it quite well. Next up, Power of the Doctor, and then we'll look at the 60 specials, 60th anniversary specials. Okay, that's a better effect shot than the one I just saw.
Hello, Doctor.
Fuck off, Doctor.
Welcome to the end of your existence.
Okay, he was good.
A dozen of the world's leading seismologists have gone missing. 15 of the world's most valuable paintings.
She was boring then. She's boring now.
Things have disappeared.
Gordon Bennett, female amounts of bloody patient.
Doctor, landing!
9.9! Can I let you in on a little secret?
I mean, okay, she's awful. She's like nails on a chalkboard. But this still is a more compelling Doctor Who trailer.
A Dalek incursion on Earth is imminent.
Has it never occurred to you that it could be a trap?
This isn't a day. You are erased forever. Bit of a conversation stopper.
if this era wasn't unending shit, this would be a fantastic trailer. It was just unending shit.
It's incredibly dangerous.
Oh, and okay, Tegan and Ace, we liked it.
Really bad idea.
Anything could happen.
Final battle. Go fuck off. Although, again, look, they're able to make a run effectively now.
I don't want it to end.
We all do, darling. We all wanted it to end.
Yes!
Yes! Icky Thump! We gotta speak the love that dare not say its name! Oh, too late, Icky Thump. I'm too scared. Now, David Tennant's back. Thank God! Doctor Who saved! Schmucks like me said. Ah.
Sometimes I think there's something missing. Like I had something lovely.
We did. It was Doctor Who. And we thought it was coming back with you, darling.
And it's gone. I lie in bed thinking.
This is a better trailer, though. Wait, everything's better than the shooting. It's the worst fucking trailer ever.
What have I lost?
No other's friend called Donna Noble. I had to wipe her memory to save her life.
No!
If she remembers me, she will die.
Okay, again, I find this more compelling. You can't really tell how like unendingly shit it was gonna be, right?
So what happens next? The spaceship crashes right in front of her. It's like she's drawing us in.
What the hell? We've got a bloody Martian in the shed.
Don't look, meet me.
Oh, here we go again. I don't believe in destiny, but if destiny exists.
Okay, you know why this is a good trailer? Because I've seen the episodes, didn't like them, and think this is exciting.
Then it is heading for Donna Noble. And I've got a memory. After a very long time, something's coming back.
Who are they?
Monsters.
Even Yasmin Finn is not too objectionable because you don't know how objectionable the whole thing's going to be.
There's something so bad the TARDIS ran away.
Yes.
Then we go and kick its ass!
Oh, if only this was as good as we thought it was going to be.
Kate Lethbridge-Stewart!
What do we do this time, Doctor? How do we fight the human race?
I remember that was the one where you had a device that made everybody always think they're right, so the people who always think they're right, who are constantly wrong, right? Constantly wrong.
Something entered this world.
Oh, but he is recognizing me.
Who is he?
The one who waits.
Okay, good trailer. I'm sorry, it's an excellent trailer.
I don't know if I can save your life this time.
Again, I didn't know it was going to end so shit, right? I didn't know it was going to be such awful shit, but this trailer's excellent.
Worldwide premiere.
Yeah, he was great as a toy maker. I'm sorry, I thought he was a great casting. Yeah, by generation, it was just shit. So Church on Ruby Road, I thought was a good episode. We're not going to watch that trailer though. Let's finish these rankings. Right, so season 11, season 12 definitely worse. Season 12, but I'm going to say season 13. 13 above that, because I thought that again as a trailer that was good. And then the specials, 60th anniversary. It was a good trailer. I'm sorry, it was a solid trailer. As trailers go, I'm gonna put up here. 60th anniversary. Fine. With that, let us have another go at the Shooting Gap with trailer, and then we'll put it in context.
completely.
Give me the loving.
That gets worse every time. Literally gets worse every time.
Where did he come from?
I don't know. He sort of popped up at the right moment. And then he spoke about time travel.
Ruby,
do you want to know my secret?
Okay, she's the only thing in this that's worth watching. I'm sorry.
I have the whole universe at my fingertips.
And I'm one of my own. I'd love it if you came with me.
Who are you?
I'm the Doctor.
Don't they change me?
Well, in this weird new revamp, yeah, reboot, yeah.
It's called the TARDIS. It's a time and space machine.
Is it safe?
No idea.
What if I change history by stepping on a butterfly?
Well, that's not gonna happen, is it?
Oh, what's wrong?
With all my adventures,
never seen anything like this before.
Oh my, Bridgerton! This place is completely...
Shit, I mean, man, there's so many bad decisions going on in this trailer. And I'm sorry, like, again, she's very good. Very good focus on Jigs Monsoon. What? Okay, let's go. Jigs Monsoon looks shit.
With all my adventures,
never seen anything like this before.
Oh my, Bridgerton! This place is completely mad.
Things seem to be turning more and more supernatural.
Is that monster?
No, don't be silly. There's no such thing as monsters. It's just creatures you haven't met yet.
Yeah. Great line delivered badly.
There are powers beyond the universe.
Right, that was the only effective effect shot I think I saw. This one over here.
There are powers beyond the universe. So vast. The whole world could slide into the pit. This is what we're trying to stop.
I'm still her mom. I need to know she'll be okay. You'll keep her safe?
I will keep her safe.
You wouldn't trust him. Sorry, mate.
I promise.
It's taken me all this time to change it.
She is the only asset this has. And they fired her.
Guys, what am I here to do? I'm going to save the world. Change
it. Everything is possible.
But, okay, I hate this. When you see the Doctor jiving.
Everything is possible.
Time may change me, but I can't trace time.
Like, here, I'm shooting Gatwa as Doctor Who. Right? It's all about him.
But I can't trace time.
It's a very narcissistic take on Doctor Who. Fine. So where would I rank this? I'm really uninterested, but I'm amazed how bad I think it is. Like, really, I am. I'm really amazed. Okay, I'm gonna have to put it down here. Season 14, stroke 1. Yeah. And we just went through them and looked at all of them. You can't argue with any of these. What, you want to tell me that the Mortal Mars trailer, which wasn't very good, was worse than that? No, it wasn't. End of Time season. No, all these trailers were way better. Every single trailer was way better. That was absolute shit. What can I tell you? Absolute shit. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, I'm off. Tomorrow I am not on, and Monday I'm not on. I will, what's we doing tomorrow? Let's have a look. I think this is the one I'm going to put out. Trying to see a screen. Yeah, I think this is tomorrow's show. The Unrelating and Unending Horror. That is modern Star Trek. It really is. We're stunning and brave, and not for the male gaze. That's a pity. Star Trek was so much better when it wasn't afraid to be sexy, which it is now. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, with that, I'm going to wrap up and say good night. Good luck, and may your God walk with you. I'm going to hit the end broadcast button.